Hi, right now you are learning how you deliver your research proposal. And here you'll find out what are the main points that you have to deliver or convey in your research proposal presentation. And I'm pretty sure that if you're able to present and deliver these points, you're also able to defend your proposal. It means you're also able to answer the examiner's question clearly. What are the points? Here you are. In your first slide, this is common that you have to present your research title first, so the audience your research proposal's title. Then you continue greeting the audience, for example, the head of the program and the secretary, the board of supervisors or consultants, examiners or reviewers, and other audience who are watching you in presenting your research proposal. After that, you have to bear in mind that a research proposal is consisted of three chapters, and they are chapter 1, introduction, chapter 2, review of related literature, and chapter 3, research methodology. The question is, what are you going to say or discuss with these three chapters in your research proposal presentation or seminar? Here they are. The chapter 1 must be explained within 1 to 4 slides. Okay, so you have to keep it short but straight to the point. In chapter 1, you can discuss this by answering this question. For example, what is your research proposal about? So here, you need to tell the audience what is the field or the area of your study. If, for example, you are from English study, okay, English department, so you can say, this is an example, okay, but actually this must be specific with your research proposal. Your research is about reading, okay, and say reading, students reading comprehension. So you tell the audience the area, the field of your research. And you continue to answer this question. Why is your research proposal important to be conducted? In answering this, you may start by explaining your interest first. Okay, so this must be your interest first. I have to tell you again that if we are novice or new to do a research, then the first thing that you have to think about is to choose the area, okay? Any kind of area that you are interested in, okay, that will be easier for you to do the rest of the research later on. Then continue telling us the gap, okay, or the audience, the gap of your research. The gap of your research is a question or a problem that has not been answered by any of the existing studies or research within your field. Or a gap is when there is a concept or new idea that hasn't been studied or needs further research. Your research question or your research problem is sourced from this gap. So you have to be clear first with your research gap. By understanding clearly your research gap, it proves that you don't reinvent the wheel. Reinvent the wheel means you don't do a similar research with existing or previous research, but you have a specific and your research is original. And then you continue telling the audience about the objective of your research. The objective of a research is the expected answer. Okay? What will be the answer to your research question that you expect? That is the objective. And then you tell the audience about the significance of your research. The significance of your research is who will be benefited by the finding or the result of your research. So normally you have two points here. The first point is theoretically that it will be in the field of research itself, okay, as a reference to the other researchers, or let's say if someone proceed or do further research after you do your research. And the second is practically. Again, if for example you're from an education field, then the contribution by your research funding, it can be for example to the instructor, let's say the teachers of English, the students, and the readers. Now we continue to chapter 2. Chapter 2, okay, this can be about 1 to 5 slides, but I think 4 slides is enough. And here are the points that you have to convey to the audience. The first point is the relevant previous research. Relevant previous research means any research, okay, that has already been done, but they are relevant with your research. So this is again proving that your research is specific. You don't do a similar research, or let's say, okay, you don't do plagiarism, but your research is original. So let's say this is specific, original, and you don't do plagiarism. That is the function of by telling the audience with this relevant previous research. And again, in chapter 2, in reviewing the literature, you have to focus with the research variables. Okay. Variables, normally they are two, dependent variable and independent variable. So focus on them. Okay. No need to tell other things out of your variables. And remember, the variables of the reviewing, okay, if you review the variables and the theories, any kind of books relating, okay, to this, to journal articles, it helps you, okay, to support your ideas or statements. That is the function if you review any kind of books, journals, or article in your research. And then, in your chapter 2, this is the main point, okay? To my opinion, this is the main point. You have to be very, very clear of how the theories applied in your research. Example, okay? You are going to prove whether a teaching method, say for example, number together, effect on students' speaking skill. Here, you have to explain clearly how number together is used, is applied in teaching the students' speaking skill. Okay? Again, you have to be very clear with this. Because in my experience, many of my students, they are confusing. They just tell us, this is my topic, this is my research proposal, but they don't get the point first of how they will do or they apply the variables, especially the dependent variable. And after that, you continue stating or formulate the hypothesis. Normally, if you are doing kind of quantitative research, then you have to state the hypothesis in this chapter. All right, and this is chapter 3. This is research methodology, and you may explain this with 1 to 5 slides. And here are the points that you have to deliver in this slide, in this chapter, I mean. So you have to answer this question. It means you have to explain this. What is the research design of your research? Is your research a kind of quantitative or qualitative research? So answer this, explain this, shortly, but straight to the point. And then, when or how long is spent, okay? So, when, it means how long. Are you going to do that in a year? I don't think so, right? If you're a student in undergraduate, any kind of institution or university, I don't believe that you'll do it for a long time. But, okay, you have to be specific, okay? You have to tell the audience your plan. And the next is, where will be your research conducted? Okay? And after that, who is the population of the sample of your research? Especially if you are talking of your research is a kind of quantitative research, then you have to explain, okay, how you take the sample or how the samples are taken or selected. If you are doing a kind of qualitative research, so normally you'll do non-probability sampling technique. But if it is quantitative, then you have to use, okay, this is mostly, but not always, I think, you have to apply a random sample technique. And after that, you continue telling the audience about the way you collect the data. Oh, this is about instrument of data collection. It means, are you going to collect or obtain the data by giving the sample any kind of test, observation, interview, diary notes, and so forth, okay? So instrument means how you obtain the data. Then, having obtained the data, and then you also need to explain how you're going to analyze the data. Statistically, okay, so quantitative must be statistically. While if you are doing, you are going to do a kind of qualitative research, so can be both, but you have to be very clear with this, okay? Because there's no difference. If, for example, you say you do a statistic in qualitative research, but is it inferential statistic or not? Be careful with this, okay? But this is the point. Just be specific and tell the audience how you analyze data, because remember, the function of the data is to answer your research questions or your research problem, okay? And after that, normally, in my campus where I lecture English, having explained the topic or the research proposal, then the presenter will be questioned or guided by the examiners or the reviewers. Having questioned or examined, okay. But before that, again, I tell you, if you explain those points that I mentioned before, it proves that you are also able to answer the questions given by your examiners, and they will allow you to proceed your research proposal to be a kind of research. And later on, you're going to report that in any kind of what we call in Indonesia as a green table examination. That's all our explanation relating to this point. Good luck and bye bye.